Hallo, hallo, Mic Test. Hello everyone, I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the third video of our playlist on backtesting. In the first video, if you remember, we have done, we have created the data frame of 5 minute interval Bitcoin prices for free using 12 data. Although 12 data does not provide that much, I would say, information in just one run, we have created an amazing for loop to make that entire data frame for free. In the second video, we talked about the engulfing using Talib. If you want me to cover playlists like this one, in which you don't have to go at any places, everything will be in just one playlist. And like this video, if it crosses 200 likes, I'll be taking this thing very seriously. And I'll be covering all the important topics in one playlist. So please like this video right now. We also created a column called engulfing in the end using the Talib library. So you can see that this is the data frame that we created in the first video. So this is like this, all this data is from the 12 data library, and the engulfing information is through the Talib library. If you want to like know more about 12 data and engulfing, I would say Talib library, then I have created some separate videos on Talib and 12 data. You should watch those videos to know, to learn more about these two amazing libraries. And I would say there's a lot of applications that is possible through these two amazing things. After that, the second video was focused to make the backtesting. And for that, we have actually referred to our code, which is this one, Bitcoin Trading Bot code that we actually created in our video on the engulfing strategy of Bitcoin Day Trading Bot. You can click on the I button to watch that video. It was around 45 minutes long, and it was an amazing video with a lot of information. I have skimmed a lot of things about that big video in my previous video. You can go through the skimmed part as well if you want. Otherwise, I would highly recommend you to watch that video on how to create that the Bitcoin day trading bot. So I used these parameters from the bot. After that, I have written these two functions on buying and selling using the paper trading simulator. Again, I have made a very detailed video on paper trading simulation. You can again click on this I button to watch that video. All these videos will be in the description box as well, so you can refer to all of them. So, and then after that, we actually made this entire strategy on core strategy and the alpha strategy, which is the satellite strategy, to make this column in the end of the final DF data frame. And in the end, we saw that our trading strategy was not that great as far as the prices are concerned. We started with $1,000 of money, and then we ended at $435 after 2 months. So we had lost more than 50% of the money using this strategy. This is a basic graph that we made. Although the Bitcoin has also lost a lot of money, but our strategy has lost more money. So yeah, maybe our trading strategy actually sucked. Anyways, but yeah, before saying this thing, I will have to go through a lot of analysis, and I'll be referring to this one. So we'll talk about the return analysis, the Sharpe ratio analysis, which actually represents the risk adjusted return. Then we'll do some risk analysis, which is actually volatility and the value at risk. We'll see what are excess returns, and then we'll make a confidence interval for one candle, such that we get to know that in any particular candle, what is what is the possibility of that candle to be in any particular range with 95.5% confidence. And then in the end, we'll see how to do the maximum drawdown. Actually, I'll cover this maximum drawdown in another video, and there will be some homework for you guys for maximum drawdown as well. So I'll come back to this code. So we have actually plotted a very basic graph using Matplotlib, and we can see that there's a lot of spread in the end of Bitcoin and our trading strategy. Now let's see, analyze all these things one by one. So let's see what is the bot return. So bot return is equal to, I'm actually referring to the mean return of all the candles. So np.mean, and then we'll have to take the returns, that the return of each candle. So for example, in this case, this divided by this, but the logarithmic return is better than the simple return. So I would say np.log, then final df id port value divided by this and then dot shift 1. Similarly, for the Bitcoin return, I would say BTC. By saying Bitcoin, I mean the buy and hold strategy. For this, it is np.this and then Bitcoin. But actually, I can provide close as well here. And then here will be close. So our bot has made an average return of this amount, and the Bitcoin would have an average candle return of this one. Actually, I'm not that interested in the absolute return. Actually, I should focus on the risk adjusted return, which is also known as the Sharpe ratio. And for that, I would need the standard deviation also, because if you remember, the formula of Sharpe ratio is portfolio return minus risk-free rate divided by standard deviation of the portfolio, considering risk-free rate to be zero. So it will be the portfolio return divided by the standard deviation of the portfolio. So the bot standard deviation is np.scd, and I'll just copy this thing here. Similarly, for the Bitcoin standard deviation is close, and then here it should be close. So the Sharpe ratio of the bot, which is Sharpe of bot, is equal to the bot return divided by the bot standard deviation, right? So let's see, what is it? It's negative for sure, because the portfolio return is negative, significantly negative actually. And similarly, the Sharpe ratio of Bitcoin would be this and then this and then Sharpe ratio of this. Now, after this, after clicking this, I would actually see that my strategy is good or bad, because if the Sharpe ratio is also, I would say, less than the Bitcoin Sharpe ratio, then it means that my strategy is actually really, really bad, and I should work on making more strategies. And it's more. Yeah. No. Okay. My strategy has actually, the Sharpe ratio is also lesser than the Sharpe ratio of Bitcoin. So strange. So the strategy that I have made, it has a lesser absolute return than the Bitcoin, and the lesser risk adjusted return than the Bitcoin. It means that it was really bad strategy. No worries. Our main focus is to do backtesting, right? So that's why we do backtesting, so that we avoid these bad strategies in our real life. So daily, if we talk about the average daily return, right, of our bot, so let me just average bot, daily bot average return, we'll have to compound it for one day, right? So the return is 1 plus bot return, and then it should be compounded by some number. So see what are like how many 5-minute intervals are there in a day. So in a day we have 24 hours, and in 1 hour there are 60 minutes. It means that 12 5-minute intervals, right? So basically we have 288. So we'll have to do it like this, then minus 1. So the daily bot average return is minus 1. Actually, let's make it in percentages. So I'll have to multiply it with 100. So it's 1.3861 or 62%, which is a negative. Similarly, for if we talk about the daily Bitcoin average return in this time period, it is minus 0.77%. So in one day, on an average, Bitcoin has lost 0.77% in last 2 months. That's really horrible, because of this crash of Bitcoin from around 60,000 to around 30,000 level, which is like 50% depreciation in the value of Bitcoin in last 2 months. And our bot has actually made more losses. So it's minus 1.388% daily average return of our bot. Interesting. So the excess return, if I talk about in daily sense, so excess daily average return is basically this minus this. It means that if I had invested directly in Bitcoin without any strategy, I would have made 0.61% more than more than having the Bitcoin trading strategy. Actually, I should not say it like more than this one. I would have lost this much amount of money, less than the amount that I lost while making the strategy. That was the thing. So in daily average sense also, we have a significant difference of 0.61%. That's a lot, daily average in last 2 months. So not only we'll have to work on increasing our return on the strategy, we'll have to work on the decrease decreasing the standard deviation as well, which is risk as well, because I am very much interested in the Sharpe ratio, and our Sharpe ratio is actually less than the Sharpe ratio of the Bitcoin buy and hold strategy, which is a point of worry, because in this case we'll have to make another strategy, or we'll have to like play with this engulfing strategy in order to decrease the standard deviation as much as possible, such that we have a higher Sharpe ratio of our strategy. And similarly, we'll try to like, the first thing is to increase to have a higher Sharpe ratio, and then second, I would say aim would be to increase the absolute return as well, such that we have some excess daily average return of our bot with respect to the buy and hold Bitcoin. So that's the idea. This number, I would say having a negative excess daily average return is not that threatening, because the absolute return does not make a very good picture of the trading strategy. The better understanding would be to analyze the risk as well. Now, how to analyze the risk? The first thing is to do the Sharpe ratio analysis and the standard deviation analysis that we have already done in order to see the risk adjusted return. The second thing is actually the value at risk model. I have made more videos on value at risk previously. You can I'll put in this I button in the description box. So I have made videos on value at risk using parametric method and value at risk using Monte Carlo simulation. Those videos were specifically made for the value at risk analysis, and in this video I will be referring to the codes that I actually made in that video. So basically, we first made a normal distribution function, and then we took the 5% from the left to calculate the value at risk. So import matplotlib.py plot as plt. I think I've already imported it. Anyways, so I've done it again. Now I will be using from scipy.stats import norm. Norm is the library that is used to make the normal distribution function. I'll run this. Now I'll have to make an x-axis, and then on that x-axis, on the basis of the standard deviation and the mean return, we'll be making the normal distribution. So x-axis will be the evenly spaced numbers from any particular number to another number. So I'm just like making an evenly spaced x-axis here. So that can be done using np.arrange. Let me do it from -0.5 to 0.0, 0.5, and then like this. So if I run it like this, so I have the array from -0.5 to 0.5 with an interval of 0.01. Now the norm dist is equal to norm.pdf, which is probability distribution function. I'll take x, and then bot return is the average return of the bot, which is actually bot return, right? Bot return and bot standard deviation. It's like this. Now plt dot plot x, and then norm dist, let's take color to be red, plt dot show. Perfect. So we have got the normal distribution. We'll have to work on the x-axis to make it look good. Let's do it like this, 0.0.05 to this one, and let's increase it by this. We'll have to work a little bit more. Should be like point this one to this one. That's perfect, a normal distribution. And now I will be referring to this portion, a straight line from this portion, such that we have the value at risk of this much portion of the normal distribution. So I will be let's see the confidence interval to be 0.05, which is 5%. The value at risk is basically norm.ppf, and then we'll have to take this confidence interval. This is actually the parametric value at risk that I'm talking about. We can do the same thing with my with Monte Carlo simulation as well. Again, like I've made two different videos covering these two different topics. You can refer to those videos to know more about it. So this is the parametric normal distribution, parametric value at risk calculation. So norm.ppf, and then confidence interval, and then bot return, and then bot std. Okay, so there's this is not ppt, this is ppf. The value at risk is this much. If I multiply it with 100, you can see that in one interval, because like we have taken this bot return and this for one interval, which is 5 minute interval. So yeah, in one interval, our bot will not make a loss of more than 0.67% with a confidence of 95%. So I'm 95% confident that my bot will not make a loss of 0.67% in just one candle. That's the main idea of value at risk. Now you'll say that why do I care by just saying one candle. Like you'd be more interested to see what will be the value at risk of one day, right? So in that case, we can directly do it by doing it like this, 288. So var of a day would be var of one candle multiplied by np dot sqrt, which is square root of n. So you can say that so we'll have to do it multiply by 100. So you can say that in one day, I am 95% confident that my bot will not make a loss of more than 11.364%, which is also a big number, very big number, but we are talking about the Bitcoin. We are not talking about stocks like Apple, right, or Coca-Cola. This is a very volatile security, and that's why the value at risk is saying that in one day, I'm 95% confident that my bot will not make a loss of more than 11.36%, right? This is the main concept of value at risk. You can do the same calculation for 1 month or 1 week as well. You just need to like multiply it with the square root of this number. Now, two things are remaining. One is confidence interval. Another thing is drawdown. I'll be talking about drawdown in my next video. So let's make our confidence interval here of one candle, right? The count is basically the number of observation in that, which is final df, if you remember, final df dot shape, and then the first one, which is this one, FAC, it was around 17,000. Yeah, so this is the count. We need count to calculate the confidence interval. So the lower is basically, yeah, considering 95.5% confidence interval, I'll be taking the value of z to be equal to 2. So the lower confidence interval is bot return minus 2. I'm considering 95.5% confidence interval. That's why the value of z is equal to 2. And then bot std divided by np dot sqrt and then count. Lastly, the upper is equal to this plus this. So you can see that I don't know like how will you will use this information, but yeah, it's better to make confidence interval of one candle and even one day. So what's the range of returns of your bot, I would say of your trading strategy, in one day or one candle or 1 week or so, such that you have an idea that you can say that you're 95.5% confident that it will go up to this much or down to that much. So you know what is the range of your investment. So I would say very, very important parameter for backtesting as well. Again, for backtesting, in my opinion, the most important thing is to see the Sharpe ratio, because that reflects the risk adjusted return, and all these other parameters are also very important, which should be considered to do the entire backtesting analysis. And you just don't refer to the absolute return, because absolute return will give a very biased viewpoint of any particular trading strategy. Yeah, in my next video, we'll be talking about the drawdown method, which is actually a different video, and I'll be referring to some different model as well in that video. But there will be an application of that model in this bot in order to have a better backtesting analysis, and that would be an amazing video, and you should definitely follow that video as well. Let me know if I missed some important thing here for backtesting analysis. Mention in the comment section. I'll be making more videos on backtesting, and maybe like from next videos, I'll be covering those things as well. So just write it in the comment section. And that would be really, really helpful. And if you don't know if something is missing, just mention in the comment section that you like this playlist, because this would be really, really helpful with the algorithm, YouTube algorithm, and my videos will get a very good, I would say, recommendation to people. So just please support me, like this video, and comment something great about my video. And if you like my work, you can tip me by buying me a coffee in US dollars or euros or Indian rupees. The links of all this I would say buy me a coffee is in the description box. And after watching these three videos, you at least like can buy one coffee to me if you want, of course. Also, as I already mentioned in my last video as well, the gift to all my subscribers is that I share my Google Drive access, and I have shared all the information of how you can get a free access of my Google Drive in my last video. And in my next video, I'll be talking about the drawdown analysis of our trading bot strategy. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you can see the drawdown analysis. If you can see that, it means that I have already uploaded it. If you cannot see it, just wait for one more day, it will be there. And over there you can see how I created this Bitcoin day trading bot to do all this analysis. And see you in my next video. Thank you so much.